First set. Jane Spector, serve.
Sue, thank you very much. Perfect timing. Here we go. The final of the Stella.
Let. Love 15.
Interestingly, Leighton Hewitt won the toss and elected to receive first. Unusual for a fast court like this grass court here at Queen's Club. Playing to his strengths.
Love 30. Love 15, 30.
Oh, big chance there. James Blake pulled back, ball was out. Taking a serious look at the linesman there. He thought the ball midway through that point was out. Ended up winning it. Luckily for him, though, Leighton. Big chance there on that point.
Deuce.
An edgy opening.
Advantage Hewitt. Deuce.
Blake just taking some pace off the serve, getting a little bit more action on the ball, a little bit more kick to take Hewitt out wide. It paid off there. He saves the first break point.
Advantage. Blake.
Now, Hewitt, one of the best returners in the game there. And you can see, even though that was a surprise tactic from Blake, Hewitt just ready. Hewitt.
Second break point on the first one. Remember, Blake went wide with the big kick serve and it paid off.
Out. Game. Hewitt. First game.
Interesting opening game. Almost 5 minutes of play there. Leighton Hewitt winning the toss and electing to receive, and that has paid off. Just to let you know what the head-to-head is between these two. They've got quite a history. They've played, seven times in all. It is 6-1 in total to Leighton Hewitt. But interestingly, the only victory for Blake was earlier this year. That was in the final of Las Vegas on a hard court. It was in three sets. They've played three times at Grand Slams. Hewitt has won them all.
Leighton Hewitt to serve. Left for serve.
A little bit of news coming in from Germany in Halle, the sort of other grass court tournament that takes place this week in the calendar. Roger Federer, a victor there over Thomas Burdick.
30-0.
And Federer's victory makes it number 41 in a row on grass, and that equals Bjorn Borg's winning consecutive winning matches on grass streak. Amazing. Federer did have to save some match points earlier in the week, four of them against Rokas. But he beat Tommy Haas in the semi-final. Now a victory in the final.
Let for serve.
I don't think his odds can get any more extreme than they already are at Wimbledon. This was even unbelievable.
Okay, Hewitt.
That was Roger Federer's 15th consecutive final in tournaments played. It's just an amazing record. So no matter what happens here, Federer goes into Wimbledon as the favourite. But Hewitt will be a factor.
15-0.
Blake needs a good game here to get himself on the board. Looked a bit edgy in his first service game.
Let for serve.
Oh, that's the sort of shot that Roger Rashid, Leighton Hewitt's coach, is after in the play, where he steps into the baseline and does something on this sort of shot. That's aggression. That's what Hewitt needs to do. And certainly a lot more successful this time.
30-15.
First time he served volleyed, he had a ball at his shoestrings. That one, nice height for a forehand volley, that one. Oh, that was a total miss hit.
40-30. Advantage. Game. Play. Hewitt leads 2-1. Time.
Yeah, was it me or was it he?
Yes.
Was he nervous?
It was your tough questions.
Leighton Hewitt, he's got what he wanted from the start of this match. He's serving with a break at 2-1. In the words of James Blake, Leighton Hewitt neutralizes the big servers. He's already done that. He's got what he wanted already, the Australian. So.
Well, that's the. Well, why Hewitt is just so effective. That first return to serve from Blake was so strong. Most other players, it probably would have been a winner, or at least given him an easy shot on the next ball. But Hewitt gets there and hits it back 2 feet from the baseline.
Ortila.
Rafter once described his countryman Leighton Hewitt. He was playing Davis Cup with him at the time. He described him as the mongrel. It was a term of affection, but you can see exactly what he means. Give Leighton Hewitt half a chance, and he'll take it.
Going to do the business.
Love 15.
You can see here, position right for an approach shot, but Hewitt really only has to move a couple of steps to wind up with the forehand. Blake not being able to get close enough to cut that ball off on the backhand volley.
Well, James Blake's having a nightmare out there now, isn't he? This is not what you want in a final. I mean, he's used to finals, though. He's been in a couple this year and won them, and won two last year, Stockholm and New Haven. His older brother, Tom.
Well, this will get a bit of confidence going.
Oh. 40-30.
Well, there's a lesson for junior players all over the world, or just club players even. When you've got a short ball like that, just shove it right down the line and get to the net, take position. Hewitt is playing a very sharp match at the moment.
Advantage, Hewitt.
That's the problem at the moment, Hewitt. His depth is so strong that Blake is now starting to go for winners from positions where he's not really the favourite to do so. It's a bit out of frustration, really.
Fortune going his way as well. Leighton Hewitt well in command of this final already.
You at least 4 games to 1.
Well, he may have been described as a mongrel by his friend Pat Rafter. I said with love and affection, but what a pedigree in tennis, Leighton Hewitt, really. At the age of 20, he was the youngest ever world number one. That was in 2001. He won the Tennis Masters Cup in Sydney to confirm that ranking. He may only be 25 years of age, but already he's played 10 Australian Opens. So he started when he wasn't even 16. Amazing. He was a finalist there in 2005, was Leighton. At Roland Garros recently, a round of 16, he lost to Rafael Nadal, but took a set off him there. So he came in with some pretty good form here and made the transition to grass very quickly. He had a bye in the first round here because he seeded. In the second round, Vicenti, well, he lost his first set, but came through 6-2 in the third. He beat Max Meynier, man he won the US Open doubles with in 2000. 7-6, final set in that one. In the quarter, finally beat Nadal. 3-6, 6-3, retired. Nadal just exhausted, really, on the left shoulder giving out. And then he beat Tim Henman from 2 love down in the final set. A couple of bad calls going against Henman, maybe, but it was Hewitt who won the match. Let's be clear about that. He's a former Wimbledon champion, and he is 3 times a champion at Queen's Club. The 3 years before Andy Roddick took over. That's his wife, Beck Cartwright, there on the right-hand side of the screen. Dad Glyn on the left.
Well, that's the first time that Hewitt's missed a first serve since this match has begun. He's dictating these rallies very well, Hewitt.
15 love.
Only 108 miles an hour, but right on the line. Doesn't have to be fast, as long as it's that accurate.
Both. 30-15.
First double. Changing direction on a grass court is a very difficult element to the movement on this particular surface. Makes the return, gets back to the middle, and then just can't make ground to the backhand side.
Thank you. Hewitt. Hewitt leads 5-1.
Fine start from Leighton Hewitt. He hasn't been in the winner's circle for quite some time. He won Sydney in 2005, but it's a year and a half ago now. It's a long time to wait for a player of his stature. He's come out hungry here.
15 love. New balls, please. You at least 5-2.
Well, something for Blake to get his teeth into there. Just winning a fairly comfortable service game. He's still 2-5 down in this first set. He's 26 years of age, James Blake, and really coming into his own now. Born and raised in New York, but living in Florida now. He's a winner in Las Vegas and earlier on in the year in Sydney. So he took Leighton Hewitt's title. He's won 5 titles in all. He's a finalist at Indian Wells, one of the big tournaments of the year. He beat Rafael Nadal there, actually. A good performance, and followed that up with a quarterfinal loss in Miami. So lost in the final of Indian Wells and the quarterfinal of Miami, both to Federer. His Grand Slam performances haven't really lived up to his potential yet. Australian Open, his best is a couple of fourth rounders there. The French, third round this year, he lost to Gael Monfils. Only 2 match victories at Wimbledon in total, which seems not much of a return for the type of tennis that he has. His best is the US Open. There was a quarterfinalist last year. He beat Nadal there and Robredo, and then lost to Andre Agassi 7-6 in the 5th set after taking a 2-sets-to-love lead. Great match that was. Beat Roddick in the semi-final here in straight sets. Revenge over Monfils for the French Open loss, and a couple of Americans, Gimelstob and Ginepri, in his first 2 matches. So that's the way Blake has made this final at Queen's Club.
Love 15.
More like it. Second serve inside the baseline, beautifully produced backhand there, took that one on the rise. Well, Blake hasn't won a point yet from Hewitt on the first serve.
Love 40.
But he's starting to get some change out of Hewitt's second serve. Again, that one a bit short. Inside the baseline, on the rise again.
Serve again for the set, but this is good news for Blake fans and the crowd, I think.
Yeah, needed to win this game.
Hewitt leads 5-3.
Get back into the match, and Leighton Hewitt there will be mad at himself. He didn't get a first serve in that game. The first time his serve has looked vulnerable.
Love 15.
It's not a bad serve either from Blake. Couldn't hit that much deeper or wider.
At least 5-4.
Okay, so three straight games for James Blake. He's got himself involved in the match, but is it too late?
Well, it's going to be an interesting game now. There was concerns a couple of games ago. It looked as if he was slightly panicking a bit, which is understandable. On a grass court best of three set match, it can go very quick if you start off badly. And all of a sudden, he's down a couple of breaks, and he's going for the aggressive shots. That's the way he plays, and he's missing. And you could see it going through his mind. I think he's got to get back in this match somehow. He started to be aggressive on the second serves from Leighton Hewitt and started to take chances, but he was getting into some rhythm finally. And of course, Hewitt gave him the second serves to have a go at. The early part of the match, he wasn't getting any second serves to have a hit at. It's going to be a very interesting game here. I'd be surprised here if Leighton Hewitt doesn't get some first serves in this game for sure. Now there's a battle on. This set looked like it was over 10 minutes ago. Now we've got a nice fight back here, and the crowd are starting to really enjoy it.
They like the story of James Blake. They like James Blake very much as well, don't they? They know about his health scares that he's had. He had scoliosis growing up, curvature of the spine, had to wear a back brace for 18 hours a day. And then he actually broke his neck in 2004, didn't he? He was practicing in Rome and fell into the net post and fractured some vertebrae in his neck. Very, very worrying. But came back from that, then got ill. So they know his story. They enjoy watching him. Now, what can he do here? Hewitt serving for the first set again.
Love 15.
Oh.
Wow, that's brilliant. And again, the
15 on.
Second serve from Hewitt. That gave Blake the chance to get in the dominating part in that rally. Ferocious forehand. Here
30-15.
That was drop shot was not good enough, unfortunately.
Go on, Gordon Banks, remember that 1970? Wonderful. So he goes back here and there, that was a mistake, but here's the move. Oh, tremendous.
Oh, very good. A gutsy second serve from Hewitt there.
40-30.
Going out wide to Blake's forehand, which is his strength at 30 on the second serve. Knew what he was doing there, and then hitting behind his man brings up set point.
Okay, the set.
But well done, Hewitt, in the end. But only just 6-4.
6-4.
Fascinating first set in the end. Leighton Hewitt 5-1 looked like the only player who had actually turned up for this final, but James Blake came on back. But it's been a long time, long wait for Leighton Hewitt. Much has happened, of course, in his life. He's 25 years of age now. That's his wife, Beck Cartwright. She was in Home and Away. She's not in that anymore. She's Mrs. Hewitt and a mummy now. And well, it's bound to alter anybody's life. Little Mia, Rebecca Mia at home. Or Mia, I should say. Just 6 months of age, so Leighton the dad.
Tremendous.
Now it's going to be an interesting start to this second set here. James Blake definitely getting into this match. You can see the way he's starting to take charge of the rallies. He hits a heavier shot than Leighton Hewitt. Leighton Hewitt on the defensive, but of course the lead was just a little bit too much to pull back. If he can start this same type of form at the beginning of the second set as he was at the end of the first, he has a good chance to pull this match out. But he mustn't let his standards drop even a fraction, otherwise Leighton will be there as usual.
Great crowd in again, of course, 6,500 people. Tickets are difficult, but Cliff doesn't have any trouble getting tickets. Must be well connected. There's Sir Cliff, and on his right, our left,
second set. Select. Lake deserve.
Having a goss about somebody in the crowd.
Sit down, please. We're starting the match. Oh, that's a bit of luck. Had two against him in the first set.
Love 15. 15 on. Left for serve. Left for serve. First game, second set.
You know, one of the lovely things about this tournament is the way the setting contributes to it. We've got the biggest east stand there on the right-hand side and a little stand at the end there. That's the traditional clubhouse over there from Victorian times. There are so many purpose-built stadiums in all sports, aren't there, around the world. But this one, I mean, goodness knows how they managed to get 6,500 people around here and actually get a license for it. But it's got a wonderful, intimate feel. There's the balcony behind Leighton Hewitt. You can see Nigel Havers up there, the actor, and alongside Cilla and Cliff. It's just a wonderful arena, all dressed up.
Cool. Didn't quite have to be that fine, but beautiful shot.
15 love.
Never 100% sure with Leighton's volleys. Even though he won the US Open doubles with Mernier, it was his first Grand Slam title back in 2000. Well, that looked a little bit 13, wide, 15. I must say.
Yeah, Blake not putting up any protest at all. Did look wide.
He's not a whinger, is he?
He's had a bit of success on that backhand at the end of the first set on the second serve down the line. That one overcooked it a little bit.
Game, Hewitt. One game.
So frustrating playing against Leighton Hewitt. It's just a nugget from the back of the court. He refuses to help his opponent beat him. Gives nothing away. I feel Blake's frustration. You can see what he wants to do. He wants to hit through him, but it's so difficult.
Love 15.
Forced error from Hewitt.
15 on. Wait, 15, 30.
did well there, Blake, because that was a big point. And from that position there, looked like Blake was gone. But he guessed right. Good pickup.
He waited, didn't he? Didn't commit too early.
Another point, really.
40-30.
Hewitt should have won that one. Good aggressive attack on the second serve, though. A change-up from Hewitt.
Deuce. Advantage, Hewitt.
Doesn't have to come out of the middle of the racket to count. Break point.
Deuce.
The ball toss there, John, seemed to suggest that Blake would kick the ball out wide, and then he went right down the middle. That was clever. If it was on purpose.
Advantage play.
Blake really having to work hard to stay in this game on his serve. Another brilliant return from Hewitt.
Game.
He saves a break point.
Blake leads 2-1.
And you always know your serve is going to be under pressure against Leighton Hewitt. You go on court knowing that if you miss first serves, you could be in a little bit of trouble. You're going to have to work harder. Let's put some meat on those technical bones now with Jason Goodall.
Thanks, Andy. It is interesting just looking at Blake's road to the final. In the first four rounds, he posted some very impressive numbers. First serve percentage was healthy and it was effective. But look at the points won on second serve. Still pretty good, 58%. But it's been a very different story today. When he's missed the first serve, the accuracy of the second serve nowhere near as good enough, especially when serving to the deuce court. A few of those dropping ever so slightly short of a decent length. And, of course, against Hewitt. You are going to pay for that. The Australian, one of the best returners in the game, takes up a very aggressive position on the baseline. And when the ball is dropped ever so slightly short, he'll move further up the court in order to take the ball on. And in that first set, Hewitt won 66% of points against Blake's second serve. Good technique, slightly shorter backswing, hitting through the ball, and always looking to get up the court to take advantage of it. And if he can continue to return this well, he's got every chance of winning his fourth title here at Queen's.
And if he does win his fourth title here, Jason, he'll join the likes of John McEnroe, who won in 79, 80, 81 and 84, and Boris Becker, 85, 87, 88 and then 1996. It was the first of Boris Becker's titles in 1985, the one that heralded his arrival on the grass courts. Of course, he went on to win Wimbledon. That was the most exciting Queens, wasn't it? See, Johan Kriek is here today. You were talking with him, John, a minute ago.
Yeah.
I
remember him losing to Boris there in the finals and saying that if Boris played like he did in the finals there, he could go on and win Wimbledon, and he was right. No one else believed him.
For Tila.
Most of the world of tennis in town now for Wimbledon, just 8 days away.
Hello. 40-15. Two games on.
Leighton Hewitt, the last man to win Wimbledon before Federer took over, and the last man to win Queens, really, before Roddick took over and won three straight. So Hewitt's pedigree undoubted, and he's playing well here. Set up 2-2.
He has hit some great winners
15 love.
Today, Blake. He just hasn't quite got the balance right at the moment.
Dirty love.
Great match, wasn't it, that James Blake played against Andre Agassi, quarter final of the US Open last year. That got America buzzing with a bit of tennis talk again, didn't it?
Well, that was an incredible match. I mean, that was one of the best matches of the year last year, without question. And he had a great run in that sort of summer season, Blake. That was really where it was like he started to really almost learned how to play it at the top level consistently. That was where he really sort of made his run. And he's a lot better player now. The certain parts of his game, his backhand has improved out of sight to what it was. And, you know, the shot selection has improved. That's the big key with him. But I think today at the moment, he's still searching for it. It's not quite there, but he's becoming a threat. Leighton Hewitt will be well aware of this now. He wants to get his man off the court here in two sets because he knows that if James Blake starts to hit form, as he did yesterday against Andy Roddick, he is very dangerous.
Would you see him as a Wimbledon champion, potentially?
Not this year, but I think he has a shot at it. He's still got to learn a little bit more variety, I think, on this surface, but he's improving all the time.
World number 7, James Blake. Hewitt at number 13. Hewitt starting a family, of course, so priorities have been a little altered, rightly so, just lately.
15 love.
Part of the game that Hewitt was doing so well at the French Open. His serve really was brilliant, and he's certainly followed that up here as well. He's been serving well all week.
Dirty love.
And that first serve out to the forehand. The first service point, he got it out wide enough and short enough. There he didn't. And there's that ferocious forehand. One of the biggest forehands in the game today, James Blake's.
40-15. 40-30.
There, the serve from Hewitt, so accurate, the first serve, finding the corners, and it's difficult for Blake to really get in charge in the rallies, and that's what Blake's a great front runner in rallies. When he can get that first strike on board, he's deadly. But Hewitt on his service games, the first serve so far, if he can keep that percentage up, keep finding the corners, it's not going to be easy for Blake to turn this around.
Out.
Overall from the chair. This is dangerous. That's a long way away, that baseline. This is the forehand. Looks to me like a great overall. Mohamed Layani from Sweden. So not called by the baseline judge, but overruled correctly from the chair.
Love 30.
Of course, it drives a player mad, of course.
Yep. 15-30.
Hewitt.
Third job.
Really on the defense there in that rally, just couldn't get into it.
And Hewitt is closing in on a fourth title here at Queen's Club.
You at least four games to three.
It's a very subdued crowd in here today because the match is pretty average so far. One feels that Blake, you know, the tactics are there. He knows what he wants to do, and he was talking about that on the stairs just outside the changing room, wasn't it? Just trying to take the initiative in the rally early on, but such is the nugget down the other end that it's just proving a little bit too difficult for Blake today.
Well, that's the way that James Blake plays. He's a high-risk player. I mean, it's all about degrees, and I think that's been the biggest improvement in his game is he's generally speaking been picking the right shots to attack. Today, he's just been off slightly, and someone like Leighton Hewitt he just doesn't give you the chance to get back in. I mean, he's a human backboard out there. And if you're having a slightly off day, he's the worst possible person for you to play. And that's really the essence of the match. Hewitt is playing extremely solid. He's serving brilliantly. Blake's trying to force the action. It's not quite right there. And, you know, and he's losing this match. And he's got to dig in here quick. Otherwise, it's going to be all over.
That's a rousing reception for James Blake. See if he can use that energy and turn it into some winning tennis here. It's not uncommon for a player to be a little embarrassed at this position. Big build up to the final, much expectation, but it hasn't happened for him and for the match so far. Long way to go for Hewitt, though. 6-4, 4-3.
Yeah, I mean, that's sort of an example. I mean, it was a decent first serve from late, not that great, and James Blake just goes for it and sort of doesn't even make it through the top of the net.
Let for serve.
See, that to me was a much better constructive point. If you looked at where Blake hit those forehands, he still went for them, but the margins were 2 or 3 feet from the lines. He wasn't going for the lines, and that's what he's been doing too much of today. The serving from Hewitt, though, has been brilliant today. Not that big, but just right close to the lines over and over again. That's just too good.
40-15.
Fabulous.
You at least 5 games to 3.
It's really a grass court lesson right now, and Blake is being given one.
Number one in the world every week of 2002, if you remember, Leighton Hewitt.
15-love.
As well as Wimbledon champion that year, so not an average player down the other end facing James Blake. Hewitt has beaten Tim Henman twice in the final here and Pete Sampras the other time. I think Hewitt might be thinking about his service game coming up in a few seconds' time. Only his first double fault.
To come at him like that.
40-30.
He's admiring his serve, standing 2 feet from the baseline, neither in or back.
You at least 5 games to 4.
He's a smart player, James Blake. He hits the ball hard, but he's a smart man. For sake, 2 years he went to Harvard. One of those years actually played on the tennis team there with his brother, who's with him here today. Just taking charge of the coaching duties while Brian Barker, the regular coach, takes a week off. There's Tom sneezing away. Bit polleny around here with all this grass, isn't it? He was a player himself. But I mean, what can he do to break serve here and stop Hewitt taking this title?
Well, this is, I mean, I think this is great situations when you watch this. I mean, I'm glad I'm not playing out there. It's fun to watch it when you get all the different feelings coming out. Hewitt knows here he's got to go out there, keep that first serve percentage up right in the corners. That's what his job is. Blake hoping for second serves, got to try and do some damage and get himself back in this match and pick the right shots to attack on. That's the whole thing. It's going to be a fascinating game here. The crowd, it's only just over an hour, this match. They're so quick between points, and the crowd know that potentially this match could really live up to something, but it's not there yet. They're desperate for Blake to break back here.
Serving for a fourth title. The Stella Artois Championship. Leighton Hewitt.
I guess there, Roger Rashid, Leighton Hewitt's coach.
Love 15.
Would not have been too happy with that. And that he had a very good chance to come in late behind that serve after the second return from Blake. Very short, and he didn't elect to go back. Tentative point.
Socks off in this game, and the errors are coming from Hewitt.
Love 30.
Won that point, that first return that Blake got to Hewitt in such trouble, but that just extra move there just got the ball back in play. A steal there from Hewitt.
There's nothing he likes more than a target at the net.
15-30 serving for the match. Not a bad approach. So accurate.
Went for broke.
40-30.
But there was no reward for the risk that he took. And Mrs. Hewitt watches Mr. Hewitt, serve at match point. He's done it all before on this very court and at Wimbledon and at the US Open. He's a great champion. And it's a happy Father's Day for Leighton Hewitt. Well, it's been a long time since Leighton Hewitt was in the winner's circle. Too long, really. It was, what, January 2005, so a year and a half ago. But, boy, he came here with an appetite. Played very well at the French Open, yep, where he lost to Rafael Nadal. That laid the foundations for this. And he is going to be a factor at Wimbledon, no doubt about that. Boy, he was hungry for that victory, John.
Well, you could just see how eager he was when he won that match. I mean, how much it meant to him. He's back, no question about it. Wimbledon, watch out. Leighton Hewitt is going to be a big threat this year.
He was love 30 down in that final game, wasn't he?
Oh, well, then the first serve was brilliant today. The way he moved the ball around, he really gave James Blake a grass court lesson today. It was an immense performance.
Good week for James Blake. He has served notice that he'll certainly be a factor. Oh, look. Team Hewitt here to see Leighton victorious in London. It's one of the reasons that they love coming to London. They can all base themselves here for Queen's and for Wimbledon and find practice facilities as well. So there you go. Daddy's first victory while she has been born. Oh, that's wonderful. There'll be more victories ahead. It was great to see Rafael Nadal here this week. Tim Henman so close in the semi-final against Leighton Hewitt. But in the ultimate analysis, James Blake didn't quite have enough in the final. But it's wonderful to see him play this week. He's been a wonderful addition to the Stella Artois. He's talking to Sue.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I know you'd like to hear from James. James, disappointing, not your day today, really.
Well, it's definitely Leighton's day. He played great, and just got to tip my cap to him. He served great, didn't make a lot of mistakes, and there's a reason he's a four-time champion.
But you've done so well here this week. You've got a lot to take away from this, though.
Yeah, learned a lot about grass court tennis this week, more today, and then I hope I can take this into Wimbledon. Thanks. I guess it sounds like I'll have a few fans at Wimbledon, so that boosts my spirits a little bit, too. So thanks to everyone here, and hopefully you guys can cheer us both on at Wimbledon.
Yeah. And just finally, James, you came here saying you didn't really know what to make of the grass courts, so just how good are they now?
Well, these courts are great. If we could take this one and put it at Wimbledon, it'd be perfect, but still, the courts at Wimbledon are beautiful, too, and I think we'll have a great time, and I'm still learning on grass, but I think I've learned plenty this week.
Oh, well, I tell you, you've given people so much entertainment here. We look forward to seeing it at Wimbledon. Best of luck.
Thank you very much.
And now from the new champion, well, old champion away. It's the fourth time you've won this.
Yeah, this is fantastic. Always love coming back and playing here, and yeah, this is great, winning a fourth time. Yeah, Andy has sort of taken it away from me. I won it three, and then he won it three, and yeah, it was fantastic to win here again.
Just how much does that do for the confidence with obviously Wimbledon just around the corner?
Yeah, it does a whole heap. You know, obviously the year I won Wimbledon, I won here as well at Stella, and you know, it just gives you a lot of confidence going into Wimbledon. You know, grass courts here are fantastic, and hopefully I can take my game and play some good tennis like I've played over this week.
Won't give you the news that Federer's won a tournament over in Germany. We won't talk about that.
Well, that's not surprising. No.
Another one. But he's obviously the one to beat, isn't he?
Oh, absolutely. He's going to be the favourite, and rightly so. He's won there the last 3 years, and yeah, he's a clear-cut world number one on you know, taking into consideration all four surfaces at the moment. So, you know, guys like James and myself and Andy and Tim and all these guys, we're in sort of the next group just under him, and we're going to try and play some good tennis to catch him.
But you've had a fantastic week here. You just seem to have got better and better. And today, I mean, you came out firing early break, and that sort of sealed it.
Oh, I don't know about sealed it, but, yeah.
You were dominant from there.
Yeah, I lost a tough match to James in the final of Las Vegas earlier this year. And, yeah, I knew I was going to have to step it up even another notch from how I played yesterday against him. And I was able to do that today. And, you know, it's just great to get back in the winner's circle.
Now, I don't know if it's the same down in Australia, but it's Father's Day here. And I know the team Hewitt are over here, your little girls over here. Any card or did Beck not sort it out?
Oh, well, I'm not a pommy, so it's not Father's Day for me yet. But, this obviously means a lot. This is the first title I've won since being married last year and also having Mia. So this means a lot to all of us.
Well, it was fantastic and congratulations on a fantastic week. We wish you well in Wimbledon. The champion, Leighton Hewitt.
Thanks.
Ladies and gentlemen, we would now like to present the Stella Artois Trophy. On court to greet the presentation party, Ian White, Tournament Director of the Stella Artois Championships. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Her Royal Highness, the Duchess of Gloucester, who will present the trophy, accompanied by the President of the Stella Artois Tournament Committee, Sir Frank Lowe. Mr. Pierre-Jean Everard, Chairman of the Board of InBev. Mr. Stuart Smith, President of the Lawn Tennis Association and Chairman of the Queen's Club Limited. Mr. Alexander Anton, Chairman of the Queen's Club. Mr. Richard Evans, President of InBev UK and Ireland. And Mr. Miles Templeman, Chairman of the Stella Artois Tournament Committee. Our runner-up, James Blake.
So James Blake stepping forward to take the plaudits from the crowd. What a tremendous effort it has been as he greets the presentation party. People are so familiar now with his story. He's become a favourite very, very
and
quickly.
And our 2006 Stella Artois champion, Leighton Hewitt.
And we know all about Leighton Hewitt. What a rugged performance this week. So easily he could have gone out to Tim Henman in the semi-final. But a strong and courageous competitor he is. And the Stella Artois champion for a fourth time. The trophy's about as big as Mia Rebecca there. And up it goes. Congratulations to Leighton Hewitt.